ready to match the stars. Scoey Mitchell. Brett Somers. Gary Berghoff. Aaron Morrow. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rivers.
Thank you.
I love.
Is this man molesting you?
Yes, and I love every minute of it.
I love your
goodness.
I love your Argyle necktie.
Thank you.
Oh, my. Boy, you look like you ought to be laying down.
You should be running for president.
All right, take your shots one at a time, folks. Bang, yes.
Not any... me, sweetheart. I think you look gorgeous.
Thank you.
I do.
When you see Kissy,
very
you'll be
nice.
Right.
No, that's
down.
Beautiful.
Yeah, but you're not going to kiss me or anything like that.
No, no. I'm right. Cold.
That's Gary's favorite joke.
All right, shall we? Are you all ready?
No. Mm-hmm.
You feel
you
full of vitality.
She looks like Tallulah Bankhead.
She does.
Doesn't she look like Tallulah Bankhead?
Talk like Tallulah Bankhead.
I remember Tallulah Bankhead.
She will now talk like Tallulah Bankhead.
Oh, Daddy, I couldn't possibly.
That's it. And do you talk like Tallulah Bankhead?
That's absolutely all right.
Now, you talk like Tallulah Bankhead.
Well, really, darling, I don't know what to say.
Gary, you talk like Tallulah.
You dirty rat.
You talk like Tallulah.
Hi, and a hello to ye.
No, that's not Tallulah.
All right, you're the only one who hasn't talked like Tallulah.
Tallulah who?
Now let's say hello to our current champion, Audrey Nevenzall. How are you?
Oh, thank you.
You okay?
I think so.
Good. You know who Tallulah Bankhead is?
Yes.
Oh, would you like to say a few words about her?
No, thank you.
Oh, okay. Listen, you're going to have a go at over $5,000 here in a moment. Are you ready for that?
I think so.
Okay, let's get right to it after this message of interest to one and all gathered here on this day in the U.S. of A., where everything is okay, no matter what you say. With Audrey Nevenzall. Nevenzall, that's an interesting name. Is that a German name?
I think it's Scandinavian.
Scandinavian, that's a Scandinavian name, like I was just saying a second ago. Anyway, it's a nice sound. Audrey, you've won the $500 up there. That means you're now playing for $5,000. But in order to collect that amount, you've got to match one of our celebrities exactly. And it's time to choose one now.
Richard, please.
All right, Richard, you are chosen.
Hello, darling.
Hello. That was last minute.
Yeah.
Now, you face me, and I will get the $5,000 question, and it goes like this. Blank pal, P-A-L. Blank pal. Okay. Boy, he didn't take long at all. Made up his mind instantly. What do you say to that? Blank pal.
Pen pal.
You think that's it? Well, I guess everybody in our studio audience absolutely agrees with you, pen pal.
Judging from the sound of the reaction in the studio, if you don't say pen pal, you're going to get lynched, buddy.
Well, I'd like to explain. Maybe I made up my mind just a little bit too quickly.
Oh, really?
Because I wrote pen.
Pen? Little lady has $5,600 credited to her account irrevocably. Now, are you ready to play another game?
Yes.
You are. She's a cool cat, isn't she? Okay, let's bring on our challenger now and welcome Glenda Burke. Glenda, you know Aubrey.
Yeah.
All right, Glenda Burke. Where are you from?
I'm from Atlanta, Georgia.
Yep.
I live here now.
You do live here now?
I live here now.
From Atlanta, Georgia.
That's right. We've had a number of people from Atlanta,
it's
haven't
nice
we?
Yeah.
You know that my grandfather was the first black politician in Georgia?
No.
He was?
He was?
Ran for the border.
Now let's find out a little bit about Glenda and her background, shall we? Scoey, what do you say,
nice.
Glenda?
Okay, I have two children.
Two children.
Little girl named Stacy and a little boy, Ryan.
Mm-hmm.
And a wonderful husband sitting here in the audience.
Your husband is here.
Mm-hmm, he's here.
Are you sure he's wonderful? Because everybody comes up here.
I think so.
My husband is wonderful. What's so terrific about him?
Oh, he's great. Believe me.
Oh, okay. I got the idea. Yeah, he's wonderful. And are you ready to play?
I hope so.
All right, here we go. I push a button. Oops. And ask Glenda to make a selection.
B, please.
B it is. Here we go. New game. The 20-year-old bride said, I just came back from my honeymoon with my 102-year-old husband. It was really an experience. There we were in our nuptial bed, me, my hubby, and his blank. Yes. There we were in our nuptial bed. Me, my husby, hubby, and his blank.
The husby was better, yeah. Yes.
My hubby.
Sounds like my luck.
All right. There's the winning card for the lady.
Just
over
hubby
there.
And me.
This word was worth $5,000.
Blank,
Audrey, and I'm delighted. All right. Everybody ready over there?
Yes,
okay,
sir.
That's for you, my dear. And this is for you. The 20-year-old bride said, I just came back from my honeymoon with my 102-year-old husband. It was really an experience. There we were in our nuptial bed, me, my hubby, and his blank.
Nurse.
Me, my hubby, and his nurse. She said he brought the nurse along on the honeymoon.
Not a bad answer at all.
No.
No.
No. But show us a really bad one.
You peaked.
No, I didn't.
I just
he doesn't
put,
have to.
I just put me, my husband, and his pacemaker.
And his pacemaker. That's not bad at all either. Isn't that good, Glenda? That's very good. Nurse is okay, too. Well, we got two good winning, charming, losing answers there. Show us another one.
Hi, sweetheart. Well, I was going to put his first wife, but she'd already passed over to the other side. I said nurse.
Nurse. There we were. Me, my hubby, and his...
nurse.
Nurse! Oh, ho! Well, she's taking a turn for the nurse.
Took you all that time to figure that out. I see. I'm glad you did that, because it's going to be another nurse.
Another nurse. Well, I had to say it before Richard said it. What are you going to say, Richard?
I'm terribly worried.
Why?
I matched Scoey with his.
Oh, dear me.
Does this mean I'm all washed up?
Yes. You're through with show business.
Oh, thank
now,
you, Richard.
Fanny Flag.
Yes.
You're going to kill me.
Why?
Well, I thought it would be more fun for her because I said doctor rather than nurse.
Really?
And it doesn't match. It's a medical person. Fanny.
No. No, no, doctor and nurse do not match. Well, you got three nurses in bed with the old guy.
Right.
Didn't they have a grand time? All five of them there in the sack there. All right, Glenda, that's yours, and your first round question will be long in 1 minute and 3.5 seconds, right after this. We'll do it again, man. All right, now, where are we here? Oh, yeah, we're the second half of round one. You ready? This is all yours, Audrey. Arthur said, my wife got a job as a dog trainer, and I think she's around dogs a little too much. When she comes home, all she does is blank.
Oh, now, darling, just one more
time. One more time for you, all right?
Martha is such an odd name for a man.
Well, no, I said, I didn't say Martha.
Oh, you didn't?
I said Arthur.
Arthur said,
my wife got a job as a dog trainer, and I think she's around dogs too much. When she comes home, all she does is blank. And that's a simple, straightforward, declarative statement.
It certainly is.
Isn't that true? All right. See, all these.
I love that blank part.
Yeah.
I think think the audience has got it.
That's
okay.
A nice answer.
Yeah.
And please don't give it to me.
All right.
That old joke?
Now we come over here to Audrey.
There are a lot of good
and
actors.
And ask her to respond. Arthur said, my wife got a job as a dog trainer. And I think she's around dogs too much. When she comes home, all she does is...
bark.
Bark.
See? See how easy it is? See how easy it is?
You tell him, honey, how easy it is.
Tell him how easy it is, Goey.
Nah, I've really got the hang of this game now.
You have. You finally got the idea.
Yeah, I hope I can come back so I can practice the hang of the game that I've gotten.
Yeah.
She said bark, didn't
she? Said bark, yes. You got
no
the
problem,
hang of
it. Baby.
Yeah.
I said scratch.
Scratch, yeah. He got the hang of it all right, didn't he? But at some other show, I suppose. What do you say?
I started to say bark. I should have stuck with my original instinct. Then I thought about my dog, and all he does is sniff.
I see. Okay. What did you say, Gare?
Well, now I'm getting worried, because I matched what Scoey do.
Oh, yeah. Scoey, whatever you got, it's catching.
And I'm starting to scratch, too.
Did you get the same disease?
I'll tell you, the questions are getting better all the time.
Oh, they buck. Is that for you, Andy?
Okay, sir.
How does the question actually go?
The question reads as follows. My wife got a job as a dog trainer. I think she's around dogs a little too much because when she comes home, all she does is blank.
Turn cartwheels?
No.
No.
Audrey said bark.
Bark. That's
bark.
Good. Very good.
Yeah.
But you know, an unemotional woman.
Who is?
This woman with Martha, isn't
it? Oh, no, Arthur. No, Arthur is Arthur. Well, Martha, there is no name.
Martha. Hold on. I know the couple well. Isn't Arthur married to Martha?
Martha.
Well, then he's seeing somebody else.
That's right.
Anyway, she comes home, rolls over and plays dead.
Rolls over and plays dead. Well, let's see. That's one for you. Let's see if Fanny can do anything for you.
Martha.
Martha. No, I was remembering my first three marriages and what happened. I said, sit up and beg.
Sit up and beg.
Yes, I had a wife like that once.
All right. Now, there goes round one, and now we go to round two. Glenda, would you make a selection?
I think I'll try B again, please.
B again. Only three people play this time. They are Scoey, Richard, and Fanny.
Oh, good.
Are you ready?
Okay.
Here we go. The Egyptian tailor said, I am now sewing the world's largest wedding gown because Wazir, the world's weirdest sheikh, or sheikh as they say over there, is marrying a blank.
Sheikh?
Wazir the sheikh is marrying a blank, yeah. Well, they pronounce it sheikh if you're over in that part of the world.
Well, say that again.
Don't say sheikh.
I have to read this. I'm confused.
The Egyptian tailor said, I'm now sewing the world's largest wedding gown because Wazir, the world's weirdest sheikh, is marrying a blank. No, you do it on the card.
Oh,
I am so glad I don't have to answer that question. I can't tell you how
to read it. Not married Martha. No. Shake would like to meet her.
Well,
why does everybody have a southern accent?
Can you read that again?
Yeah, one more time. You're right. Shall I do it upstairs? In your ear.
You're not here.
The Egyptian tailor said, I am now sewing the world's largest wedding gown because Wazir, the world's weirdest... The world's weirdest sheikh is marrying a blank. The world's weirdest sheikh is wearing a blank.
Not wearing, marrying.
Marrying. He's marrying.
Martha, the world's weirdest sheik.
I like that answer.
The world's weirdest sheik is marrying a blank.
Oh, I like that one too.
Okay. Everybody ready, so we'll come over here. Did you finish, Fanny?
Wait a minute.
Well, put one in the slot there now. Got it.
We saw it.
Glenda. The Egyptian tailor said, I am now sewing the world's largest wedding gown because Wazir, the world's weirdest sheik, is marrying a...
elephant.
Elephant.
What a good answer.
That's not bad. That would make a large wedding gown, wouldn't it?
Audrey needs how many to win?
She needs...
Three to win. No, three to win. Well, it depends on what Glenda does in this round.
Oh. You only need three to win.
You're not going to help her, huh?
I really didn't dig the question.
You didn't?
No, I didn't even understand it.
Yeah.
The only enjoyment I got out of it was when you whispered.
Oh, I see.
Well, I said he's marrying a group.
A group.
Rock and roll group.
A group, okay.
There seems to be some hostility.
Yes, there is. Well, the group is hostile there. Oh. Okay, Richard, he said group, and...
Well, he was weird, wasn't he?
Yes, he was weird. She said elephant.
So what?
Yes.
They don't have elephants, darling, in Egypt.
Don't they?
No, my goodness me.
What do they have in Egypt?
He was marrying a pyramid.
You cannot marry an inanimate object.
Well, he's weird, isn't he?
Yeah, but not that weird.
Don't tell me. Tell Martha.
Fanny, what do you say?
I say pyramid.
Yeah, there you go. Wait a minute. Audience, what do they have a lot
camel.
Of in Egypt?
Camels.
Camels. Walk a mile
is
for
what
a
they
wife.
Have a lot of in Egypt.
Oh, that's it's all right to marry a camel, huh?
That's yeah. right.
Pyramid.
Oh, you want to do a little bit of business here. All right, Glenda, that's three for you. Now, when we come back, you'll need two to tie and three to win. But and what we're coming back from this in about 2 minutes or so.
Today's consolation prizes are Hanford Ford Stainless from Washington Forge. Complete service for tile, carefree stainless, and a walnut chest. Beautiful Hanford Ford Stainless. And Joe DiMaggio says it's the greatest automatic coffee brewing system ever. The original Mr. Coffee and genuine Mr. Coffee filter. And new Olympic Overcoat, the first exterior coating specifically formulated for redo over old paint. Don't repaint, put on the overcoat. Match Game 75, starring Gene Rayburn, continues in a minute.
Here we go. Ready? Two to tie, three to win. And I and the opposite shore shall be. Hey, Johnny Olsen's beautiful wife Penny said, quote, last night it was very hard to sleep. All night long, Johnny kept shouting, blank. You don't write. You're the only one who doesn't write. Everybody else does. Johnny Olsen's beautiful wife, Penny, said last night it was very hard to sleep because all night long, Johnny kept shouting, blank.
Johnny kept shouting?
Johnny Olsen.
No, that's Johnny.
That's Johnny Olsen.
No, but the wife...
She couldn't sleep because he kept shouting, blank.
Good
now,
question.
You
I
write
like
down
that.
There what he was shouting all night long.
Got it.
You don't know too much about Johnny's career, do you?
No, I know a lot about Johnny, though.
Oh, you do?
Oh, yeah. Old town stuff.
Oh, really?
Well, I wouldn't steal it.
Come on now, let's do this.
I'm in there.
Oh, you're in there. You're not in there.
Boy, Gene, you're getting impatient.
Wait, see, I can't see the light.
Just because your plane is waiting for the East Coast.
No, I'm staying tonight.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Oh, I've already made the reservation.
All right, here we go.
I understand that has a kitchen and everything.
Yep.
No.
Now, Audrey, Johnny Olsen's beautiful wife Penny said last night it was very hard to sleep. All night long, Johnny kept shouting,
come on down.
Now, for the edification of those who may not have seen it, Johnny Olsen, of course, precedes us with Bob Barker on The Price is Right. And when the people are chosen out of the studio audience, the audience is a little higher than you are. They're on,
have
I don't
him
know.
Do it.
Yeah. All right, come over here, John, and do it.
There. I hope so.
You know, when someone is chosen from the studio audience to come and participate on The Price is Right, he gets them to the stage by saying,
Gene Rayburn, come on down!
Okay. Should have done all that before. Now, do you get the idea now, Scully?
Yeah, I'm starting to get the hang of this.
Yeah, yeah. Why don't you put it in a car? He just said, come on up. Come on up.
What did you put on the card, though? That's what we want to know.
The clue that you gave me was really what I should have gone for.
I said, you know anything about his career?
His career. When you said career, then I should have right away picked up on that. But I know him personally, and his wife said it was hard for her to sleep because Johnny Austin kept saying, wake up.
Okay.
Well, I had to say something.
You sure did. Now, Brett, what do you say?
Well, I never see the prizes right because I have to drive Gary to his psychiatrist at that time. So I said, he said, hi there.
Gary?
Oh, well, you're blank.
I said it. I said, Johnny said,
come on down.
What did you say? All night long, Johnny kept shouting, what do you say, Richard?
Come on down.
Come on down. Hey, tie score, one more. Come on down. Win the game. What do you got there?
Oh, stop.
Come
now,
on.
Are you happy?
Are you happy? Where the heck did you get that dumb idea from? Well, we got a tie score here, 3-3, and now we got to do a commercial, and then you come back. Come on back. Hey, it was just grand. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Tubman production.